The battlefield knows no color, race, or creed. The exception is the color purple. Set aside to honor instances of bravery, the Purple Heart Medal is awarded for unusual gallantry in battle and extraordinary fidelity in service.
What kind of reverence is there for the Purple Heart Medal?
So if you're talking to a veteran that received the Purple Heart, they would say, I didn't duck fast enough. But anybody else looks at it as in awe, you know. All soldiers sign their name on the dotted line and will give anything up to and including their life for this country and for our freedoms.
And it's that sacrifice and service that's recognized here at Florida's Purple Heart Wall exhibit, permanently housed inside the Southwest Florida Military Museum.
It was a traveling wall for several years that went up and down the state of Florida. And they called us one day and said, would you like to permanently place this because we don't want it in storage anymore? And they came in, they actually helped us build this.
Featured prominently are Florida service members who died defending our country. The photo panels start with recent history.
Any of the multiple Gulf Wars they could have been serving and lost their life. Our very own Daniel Eggers from Cape Coral is right here. He's the third one in on the top. And we actually have a memorial that his father made.
It's no surprise this monument to service made its final resting place here.
We have such a great military culture here in Southwest Florida. Cape Coral actually was the first city in Southwest Florida to become a Purple Heart city.
The great equalizer, the Purple Heart, was the first military award given to officers, enlisted soldiers, and non-commissioned soldiers alike. It shares a place of honor among collected memorabilia from wars gone by.
Over 24,000 items are in here that have been cataloged that would be some type of artifact or item, and then over 6,000 nonfiction military books, which is quite significant.
During the World War II period, there were like 650,000 Jeeps, military Jeeps. They're called quarter-ton trucks.
Jim Zeebeck's interest in collecting was born from his father's service in World War II.
He was a mechanic, so he was in the motor pool. So he would have dealt with vehicles like this.
Paying tribute to those who sacrificed is the primary mission of the War Museum.
Well, that's one of the reasons why our museum exists, is to spread that knowledge and also to inspire the younger people to take an interest in it and show what the veterans have done for our country.
The Purple Heart Wall sparked great interest when it debuted on August 7th.
Which was National Purple Heart Day. We had about 500 people in here for that.
The faces they gaze upon are not alive to look back.
He looks so young.
He was young then. It was 2004 and, you know, he was a kid.
The Purple Heart Wall is a top draw for visits, among veterans in particular who pause in memorial.
Does it bring them back? Because when they served, in all likelihood, they were probably within this age group.
Yeah, they wouldn't tell you if it did, but I would say yes.